It's Deb, and I'm going to do a DT challenge for Angela Holt's The Bling Chronicles, and it's the challenge is going to be to make a wind chime. You can make your wind chime out of anything you like, but today I'm going to make one to show you what I decided to do. So if you've watched any of my other videos, one of the videos I have is making these little flowers out of pop tabs. Or soda tabs if you're from the South. Shut up, Crystal. Crystal hates it when I call these pop tabs. So, anyway. You can make them out of any kind. I happen to have pink ones, and then I also had some plain silver ones, and so I painted those bronze because the piece that I'm going to use for my top, which looks like this, is bronze on the back. So, or copper. Whatever you want. This is copper, and this was copper paint too. One of the things I wanted to show you when you're doing this, you're going to want to seal it so it's waterproof, and you can, if they're already colored and you want to leave them colored, use a clear spray. For the copper colored ones, I used automotive paint, and it works great because it's waterproof and it gives really good coverage and it's really shiny, like, you know, real copper would be. So. Okay, so just a quick review on how to make flowers. You're going to take your punch, you're going to take a pop can that you cut apart, and just punch a circle. Okay, that is going to be your base. Now I've painted mine pink, mainly because I wanted to show you, you know, if you paint it like this with acrylics, it works, but you got to seal it. Okay, and then you're going to take your pop tabs, and I painted the backs of mine, and then sealed it so that it would, you know, when it flips in the wind or whatever, it'll look pink on that side. Now, most of these I've already taken the little part off, but sometimes you'll get them, you'll take them off, and they'll have these little thingies on them. You can either bend it off, which, you know, it's pretty easy. That's the easiest way. Or you can take your handy-dandy little wire cutters, bend it up. Oh, it fell right off. But anyway, you would just clip it like that. So whichever you want to do, whichever you feel safer with. Okay, then to build one, the first thing you got to do is drill a hole in it. Let's see, where did mine, there it is. Okay, yeah. Normally I would just have this out, but I can't get it out because someone else put it in there. So you would just take this and spin it. For today, I'm going to drill it. It only takes a second if you're doing it by hand, promise you. Okay, there we go. Much easier to do it by hand, trust me. Okay, once you've got that, then you're going to go in here and just like bend these pieces so that they're flat, because you don't want them to cut your string. And I'm just kind of tearing them off, and then I'll straighten them out. Okay, so there, I've got a hole in the center. And now I'm going to attach my pieces, and I'm just using a glue gun. And first thing I'm going to do, sorry, is put a little glue right here. And then stick it on. I stick mine on so that they're just, this little circle part is just past the edge of your inner circle. Okay? So this part right here would be just past the end of your inner circle. Now, best way to do this to get them even, or fairly even anyway, is to do them opposites. So I'm gonna put that one on, and then I'll go back and do my sides. And I kind of bent it so with the drill. So there we go. Okay. And remember, it does not have to be perfect because it's going to be covered with all of these, so it won't matter. And then I'm going to go in and put that one in. And that one. And this one I'm going to go right in the middle of the two, like that. And then on the opposite side again, like that. And like that. And the last one, right there like that. Okay, so now you've got a flower with a hole in the middle. Okay, now, because I'm gonna use this outdoors, I'm going to flood fill this side with my glossy accents just to make sure that it doesn't come apart because it's gonna be clinking against the wind chime in the wind, so I want it to be, you know, pretty sturdy. So I'm going to fill that in. Okay, so that one's completed. It would just have to dry. So I'm going to set that aside because I've made whole bunch of them. Okay, so I've got 11 of each color. I don't know how many I'm gonna use yet, but I just wanted to be prepared. Okay, so the next thing I need to show you after you've made those, my chimes are going to be these metal pipes. And they're copper colored. And this copper is a kit that I bought. It's actually for refrigerator ice maker kits. And it was $20 for the whole set. And as you can see, it's a lot of copper. So I could get probably to at least 10 or if not more wind chime things out of it. Okay. And it comes with this handy dandy little thing here because it is very hard to drill a hole in a rounded object. So if you see, it's got this spike thing that you put your copper in here and you tighten this down and then you spin this and it pokes a hole and gives you a starter for drilling. So that made all the difference in the world because I don't think I would have been able to drill it without that. You could probably just poke a hole on both sides if you wanted to too. If you could, you know, make a little line and make sure it got even or whatever. But anyway, that's how I did it. We drilled it. So I'm going to put this sticker on here now. Set it aside. Okay, so that gave me, I cut three different lengths. And then this is going to be my top piece. And I'm going to put some fishing wire through the holes here and attach these. And then I'm going to put more fishing wire and make a dress of sorts around it. I also bought beads and I may intersperse those. So I bought these at these are on sale at Michael's for buy one, get one half off, so they were $4. So I ended up spending, $6 for two. So that's not too bad, because I won't use all of them and I'll have it for another project. And same with this, I got another different color bead, but that's what I wanted, because they kind of went with these little beads on here. Okay. All right, so I'm going to put it on pause now and take everything apart so that I can go ahead and start assembly. Okay, y'all, I'm back, and I just want to show you kind of what I did off camera. I took my little top piece that I wanted, my corset, and I put rings through these, and then put the other two on the one, so it's, you know, so they're attached like that in kind of a triangle. And then on the back, I did a fisherman's knot. And if you don't know how to do a fisherman's knot, best way is to watch somebody do it online. But I can show you real quick on this. If you, hopefully you can see this because it's clear. But you make a loop and you twist, twist. You're gonna go around three times. And then you bring this back up through the hole like this and pull. And that's a fisherman's knot, but you have to pull it really tight. I'm not going to do that because I need to use this, but that's how you make a fisherman's knot. And that's how I attached this on there. First I put, you know, a piece of it through the loops right here, through the holes. So that piece is ready to go. And I made some of the dangly pieces offline, but I'm going to make one so you can see what I'm doing. So this one, I want this at the bottom, so I'm going to come up through here and I'm going to put a, whoops, wrong one. I'm going to put a clear bead on first and bring that down to where I want it. Okay, then I'm going to take this piece, the shorter piece, and stick it back through so it makes like a loop around it. Okay, so it's like that. Okay, now I don't want it laying sideways like that, so I've got to bring this around. And loop it back through. So it will stand up straight. Okay? And I'm going to do that fisherman's knot now around the bottom. Just make a loop and then I'm going to twist, 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 and put it through the loop. Oops, I lost it. Hang on. Twist, 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 and I'm using 50 pound test weight, so it's a little stiffer than I really wanted, but it's what I had on hand, so. Okay, I'm going to grab it, and I'm going to pull tight. Okay, so it's going to kind of look like that at the bottom. You can see the big loopy thing. Okay? And then I'm just going to cut my tail off a little bit. And so that doesn't stick up. Okay, so there's, I've got that one on. Now I'm going to take one of these metal ones and slide it all the way down. Come back up through the other loop. Other end, and you can see it's kind of hard to fit it on all the way straight, so you just have to slide it and then pull. Okay, so now we've got that part. Excuse me. So then I'm going to take my next one, and this part is a little tricky because you want to make sure that it goes on straight, so lay that out, and then I'm coming up. Through the hole, but I don't want it to go behind, so now I've got to come back down under it, make sure it's straight, come back down under it like that, okay? So if you can see that, there's the piece right there, and I'm coming back down under it, okay? And now I'm just going to stick a dot of glue so that that stays in place. I'm going to take my glue gun and make a tiny little dot right there. Let that dry for a second. might need a little bit more, so I'm just gonna stick a little bit more right there. And don't worry, the hot glue gun is not going to melt your fishing line unless you have really thin fishing line or unless you leave the glue gun actually touching the line. Okay. Okay, then you're gonna come up behind it again. And back up through the middle again. And up to the top. Put this on here. Where you want it. So now you gotta make sure you go to the right loop that's directly across on your from your bottom piece. Okay. And actually I did that wrong, so you don't come back up through the middle, I'm sorry. You're going to go up the back, find your place, right there. And then just put a dab of glue on it again. Okay, waiting for it to dry. I totaled up the cost of making this, and it came out to, let's see, the corset was on sale for $4. It was originally $6, and I got it on clearance for $4. These metal beads, the strand that I showed you, I used one strand of them, so that was $3.99, which was $4. And then I used half of the pink bead strand, this one. Actually, I only used a quarter of it because I've got one half of it and then another quarter or another half of the other half left. So a quarter of it, and it was $2, so that's 50 cents, if my math is correct. Is that right? Yeah, 50 cents. So I used $4.50 in the beads. And then the chimes, I just guesstimated. I figured I could get 10 out of that roll of stuff, so I figured that the chimes were $2. The fishing line I had on hand, if you don't, then there's probably an expense for that. And then those little rings that I attached, these were 10 cents a piece, so 30 cents there. So your total is $10.80 to make this. But again, you can, you know, make it out of other things. You don't have to use that expensive of beads. It's whatever you want to do. Okay, so that's dry, and now I'm going to slide this bead on all the way down and come back up through the other side.
It's hard to say that I'd rather stay awake when I'm asleep, because my dreams are bursting at the seams.